Fluent, the all-in-one document generation platform that unites a robust engine, a centralized template manager, and low-code designer tool, enabling users to rapidly create, manage, and deliver consistent, well-formatted documents. What is document generation or automation? It's simply to automate the creation of distinct documents from templates that combine segments of pre-existing text with dynamic data to assemble a new document. Examples might be commercial documents like orders, invoices, shipping labels, or packing list. Agreements or contracts like a bill of sale, employment or licensing agreements. Customer communications like correspondence letters, notifications, or monthly statements. Really any document that you might want to create for business. Fluent is made up of three components, and the first one is the designer. It's simply a Microsoft Office plugin, and it's going to allow your users to create Word, Excel, and PowerPoint files for your document templates. Now, the beautiful thing about that is everybody already knows how to use Microsoft Office applications, so just about anyone can design and even test your document templates. Our next component is the manager, where you will store and manage the templates you create with the designer. The manager is connected to multiple instances of the engine and offers user-based permissions with versioning and promotion paths between environments. Promote or roll back versions with ease. The manager also allows updates directly from the designer. And our last piece is the RESTful API that you can embed into any application. And when you're ready to generate output from the document template you created in Office, we can do that in any output format you'd like. DocX, XLS, PowerPoint, HTML, PDF, straight to printer. We even support a number of image formats today. So you have a add-in to Office that allows me to build my templates with unrestricted formatting. You can do whatever you'd like. A manager where you can store the various versions between your staging environments, and a RESTful API that only requires three inputs: the template you want, the data you want to consume, and the output format you want returned. That's it, simple. As you can see, as I exit out of the PowerPoint, you'll see Fluent and Fluent Tools here at the top of your screen. I just wanted you to see that we have a number, we have this in PowerPoint as well. We're one of the few vendors that allows you to automate the creation of PowerPoint or slide decks. I'd like to start the designer demonstration using the investment fact sheet. It's a densely packed one pager that has a variety of data elements. I get tabular data on past year's performance, a line area chart here that shows growth of the fund over time, and an asset allocation chart shows how the fund is allocated. In addition to that, you'll see the use of conditional formatting in this template in two places. Here, the if tag that surrounds this chart tag, checking to make sure the data is present before it attempts to render the chart, as well as here on the right where we're evaluating risk level. And based on that test condition, we'll bring in our own image and text. So above and beyond the charts and graphs already supported in Office, you can bring in your own images to punch up the look and feel of your documents. I'll direct your attention to the top of your screen here, Fluent and Fluent Tools. This is the add-in. It's the same in all three environments, PowerPoint, Word, and Excel. You'll find that icons are grouped in these functional groups like data, tags, output, you know, options like redirect to my website or wiki where I update my license key, find out what version I'm running, or set global options like locale. For the most part, you're going to do all your work right here on the Fluent ribbon. Typically, the first step in template design is to connect to a data source. Fluent can connect to one or multiple data sources. In fact, we can even correlate data from two disparate data sources if they share a field in common. Once I'm connected to the data, I can view it directly with the data bin. So if I'm connected to SQL, I'll see tables and views. If I'm connected to XML or JSON, I'll see the hierarchy of that data, where the objects and arrays exist. Great way to look at structured data. The input parameters allow me to create runtime variables. Values that I pass in at runtime to either add to the content of the document or to filter the where part of your select statements down to a specific record. Examples might be order ID, customer ID, starter end dates. There's really a lot of reasons why you might use an input parameter. The tag tree, this is my favorite tool on the ribbon. It reads the template the same way you and I do, from left to right, top to bottom. And as it encounters tags, it writes them out to this XML file I can see on the pane to the far right. Now, not only is it a clever way to navigate the structure of your template and see the values of your tags, but the reason why I like it is the ability to save it off to an external XML file that I can open in a text editor and quickly find any variables that might be causing me trouble. Once they're located, I pull on a tag, and I've got plenty of tools right here in the ribbon to help me debug any issue. The preview button will show me what values are currently being returned by the out tag, if it's going to be the data that I expect formatted the way I intend. If not, I've got a drag and drop interface for the select wizard that lets me build out any SQL, XPath, or JSON or JPath queries without having to know the syntax. I simply drag and drop the columns that are relevant to me. And if that weren't enough, I've got over 400 macros here to allow me to transform the data that I read in. I've got everything from string manipulation and text macros. I've got date and time macros, like add 60 days to a date. I've even got logical ones that allow me to do if or if error that are quite useful. The Fluent tagging language is very simple because it only has 16 tags. With these 16 tags, you can build out any kind of smart documents you'd like. And what I mean by a smart document is a single template capable of producing multiple outputs based on the data it consumes. And the way we're able to achieve that is with the use of these conditional formatting tags, if, else, and if, and switch case logic, where I basically set up a test condition inside the document. If it evaluates true, then the content following the tag is displayed. Otherwise, it isn't. These blue tags you see on the screen, those are out tags. They're bound to data, and they'll be replaced with that data at runtime. An import tag is how I bring in sub-templates, images, signatures, other documents I want to be a part of the generated output. A set tag is just like an out tag in every way, except it doesn't show up in the output. It's typically used for calculations or inside the context of loops for aggregating numbers. I've only got two data tags, the for each and the query. Although the out tag can do an independent select against the data source, my template wouldn't be very efficient if every tag had to call the data source, so whenever possible, we're going to load up a for each or query tag with all the columns of data that your document requires. The difference between the two tags is also simple. The query tag holds a single record, and the for each and int for each is how I iterate through the related list or mini side records. So I might load a customer record into a query tag, and then I could reference that with my out tags and output the company name, address, phone numbers at the top of a document. But then to iterate through the number of transactions or orders with that customer, I might have a table of repeating records because everything between these two records repeats for each record in the record set. We've already discussed my conditional formatting tags. You can also produce hyperlinks in the generated output, bookmark links that are helpful in navigating really large output, and a chart tag that's unique to Fluent in this way. When I drop a chart tag into a Fluent template, I stop using the chart design ribbon. That's for native charts with embedded Excel spreadsheets. We're going to feed this tag data directly from the data source. So you basically supply it with a query. The resulting record set that's returned by your data source becomes the series data for the chart. And then you go back to using tools you're already familiar with in Office to further stylize this image or visualization. So full reign of the format ribbon. Another cool feature about the ribbon is the implementation of a engine right here. So as a template designer designs, they're going to want to see if their previous edit improved or didn't improve the generated output. So I can generate output right here on the ribbon. It's going to go out to the data source, extract the data, replace the tags, and hand me back a well-formatted document. I'll place the output here on the right, the template used to generate it here on the left. I'll size those so you can see them side by side. You see conditional formatting in a ribbon based on risk level. All the data, including these visualizations, are dynamic. As I page break on change of fund, and redraw this data, this template with new data. So as you can see, you can build really attractive customer-facing documents using Fluent. Here's the best part. When you're satisfied with the output the template produces, this is how easy it is to embed in your applications. With just one click, I can see the code needed. And it's always the same, the template you want, the data you want to consume, and the output format you want returned, report PDF, report docx, report HTML, whatever format that you require. This is very low to no maintenance code because once it's embedded, you're just managing this Office document moving forward. There's no need to return or make edits to this code in the future. If I need to make an edit, I simply open it in the designer, I make my edit, and I hit save. And I'm going to see that the very next time it's generated in the output. Now, before I exit out of the designer demo, I'd like to show you this integration with the manager. It allows me to log into my workspace in the template manager and upload a new version of my template with comments right from the designer. When I click upload, you'll see I uploaded the template to the manager successfully. Okay, let's take a look at the manager and what features and capabilities the manager makes available to us. I'll start by going to the login page. I log into the manager, and the very first view is my template view. I can filter these templates by file name. I can filter by the file type, if it's a presentation, PowerPoint, or document, docx. I can filter by any number of labels that I produce. So there's a lot of ways that I can filter, that I can see or show or what templates I want to work with. At this level, I have the ability to download a copy of the template, make a copy of it or delete it. If I drill in on the template, you can see what version is in development, what version is in QA. I can even go into the version history here and promote a template. So if I wanted to come in here and promote this template to production, it's just that easy. You see it moved to production. I want to promote this one to QA. It's just that easy, and you see what environments they're in. I have the ability to promote, undeploy, or roll back any version. And if your permissions, you can get very granular on the permissions if the defaults are not acceptable for you. I have a view for my templates that I can filter, I also have a view for those data sources, those connection strings to my SQL data sources, my endpoints, my XML, my JSON, Salesforce, OData, whatever. And it's filtered in the same way. I can filter on labels, I can filter on type, I can filter on name. And that's what allows me to preview these templates when I'm in this view here. I can see what the output would look like when it previews. I can see what versions are in each environment right here that I'm connected to. And I have the ability to preview by pulling up that connection string and actually preview the whole document, not just the thumbnail, if I choose to do so. And so this will allow me to see what kind of output is produced by this template. Let me get out of here. I've already done that. When you're setting up the manager, you have a few settings that you have to establish at the start. These advanced settings are typically set up during the install process. You're going to set up a workspace, and that workspace name matches the URL. So you'll be able to decide the workspace, the server motto, what you want to show in your workspace, SMTP settings, or if you're going to set up email, so I can send email to my users and show them their logins and credentials. It's not required though. Clearing the workspace will delete all my templates and my data sources, so be careful when you use this. I have the ability to customize the theme editor, so I can change some of the look and feel of the environment with the theme editor. I can also set the maximum number of templates that the manager will maintain. The default is 100, but it's configurable. I can also require versions when I upload new versions, and I can optimize images if I choose to do so. You also have the ability to build out users. You can add new users, assign them to any one of these three default security groups. If these security groups don't satisfy you, you can create new security roles here that are custom. You can come in here and add, edit, or duplicate roles. And I also have the ability on the users list to modify the user's role, add them to additional security groups, or move them from one security group to another. Every instance of the manager is set up to one or multiple instances of the RESTful engine. It's very easy to add one. You just give it a name and a URL of the endpoint, authentication if it's required. These production QA and development environments I've connected to are a part of my promotion path that I define. I can add stages here, and I can assign instances to every stage, and I can have one or multiple instances in each of these stages. You have the ability to configure an unlimited number of labels to allow you to filter out all your views, and I can look at my own login credentials and reset my password if I choose to do so. I also can see what version of the manager I'm currently running. Now, what does it look like to call the RESTful API to generate output from one of these templates? Well, let's take a look. I'm putting a request body here at Notepad++ so you don't see the word wrapping. It's easy to see all the parameters. You indicate what output format you want returned, PDF, the name of the template that you want to generate output from. The URL is just what I'm going to use in the manager. It's a docx template, and I'm going to pass it some data here in the payload. So I'll copy all that, and I'll paste it over here in my Postman instance. I'm going to hit this post v2 document with a request body. When I do so, it's going to answer back with a GUID. You see it here. It answers back with my request for a new document generation request. And then all I have to do to fetch back this document is I'm going to let the browser do it. I'm going to come over here to the manager. I'll open up a new tab. It's the endpoint v2 document, the GUID you just received back from the engine, /file. I'm going to let the browser decode it for me. And just like that, I'm looking at my generated output. I can see all the pages, all the data that's been filled out, and my complete document that's been generated here. It's quick, it's easy, and you can download, install, and configure all my products in under an hour. I'm available via screen share to do just that. You can send us an email, or I can schedule a screen share with you to help you get this installed and configured. Please visit our homepage, our documentation, our trial signup, and you can sign up to have all these things sent to you in an email. You can install and configure them on your local system and start playing with our DocGen solution. Thank you for your time and attention. I appreciate you attending today's webinar. Now I'll answer any questions you might have.